Good morning, students. This is K. Lakshmi, Assistant Professor, the Department Actively, Chebrolu Engineering College, Lecturer 17, Unit 1, Topic, Solved Problems on Electric Potential. Now, in this video lecture, I would like to discuss about problems on electric potential. Electric potential is indicated by the letter V. It is the work done to move a point charge from infinite to at the point where the potential we have to calculate. That is the definition of potential. Now let us discuss the problems on electric potential. Here a point charge Q 0.4 nanocoulombs is located at the origin. Obtain the absolute potential at point A 2, 2, 3. Now potential of A due to a point charge Q at the origin is expressed as VA is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught RA. Here point A is with coordinates 2, 2, 3, and Q is at the origin, its coordinates are 0, 0, 0. Now in this formula, the RA means the difference between these two points, the distance between these two points. So that distance we have to easily find, 2 minus 0 whole square plus 2 minus 0 whole square plus 3 minus 0 whole square. So this value is equal to root 17. Now substitute the values Q and RA in this formula. That is, Q value is 0.4 nano coulombs. So to convert the nano into coulombs by multiply with 10 power minus 9, so Q value is 0.4 into 10 power minus 9 and divided by 4 pi into epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10 power minus 12, and RA value is equal to, we have already find that value, that is the distance between A and Q points, that is equal to root 70. And by calculating these values, the potential at point A is equal to 0.8719 volt. The units of potential is volt. So here the potential of expression is based on the, or the reference is at infinity. Now the next problem, if same charge Q is equal to 0.4 nanocoulombs in is for example is located at 2, 3, 3, then obtain the absolute potential between the points A 2, 2, 3. Now the potential at A is expressed as Q by 4 pi epsilon naught RA. So here RA means it is the distance between Q and A. So the difference between these two vectors is equal to RA. So it is easily obtained by subtracting these two points here, 2 minus 2 whole square plus 3 minus 2 minus 3 whole square plus and 3 minus 3 whole square. So here 2 minus 2 whole square is 0 and 2 minus 3 whole square is 1, 3 minus 3 whole square is 0. So finally the distance between Q and A value is equal to 1. Now substitute the values of q and ra in this formula. Here also charge q is equal to 0.4 nanocoulombs, and it is converted into coulombs as multiply with the 10⁻¹. So that's why it is equal to 0.4 into 10⁻¹, and 4 pi into epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10⁻¹² into Ra, that is equal to 1. Now by calculating these values, finally the potential is equal to 3.595 volt. So the next problem: if the point P is at -2, 3, 3 in the same last problem, obtain the potential difference between the points A and B. This is different from previous problems. In the previous problems, we have to find the potential. That means the difference is at infinity. Whenever you find the potential difference, the starting and ending point are known points. That means known values. So the potential difference between BAB is simply potential at A, difference between potential at A to potential at B. So first we find the potential at A and the potential at B initially. Now we have already in the previous problem potential at A value is already we have to find the potential at A is 3.595 volt. So the potential at B we have to calculate it. So the expression for potential at B is VB is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught RB. Here the RB is the distance between the point B and to the Q 2, 3, 3. So we easily find the distance between these two points by the formula. RB is equal to square root of here -2, -2² 3, -3² and 3, -3². So here 3, -3² 0, 3, -3² is also 0. So here the -2, -2, that is -4² so this value is equal to 4. So substitute the values of Q and RB in this formula, we easily find the value of potential at B. So the charge Q is also given, that is 0.4 nanocoulombs, and it is equal to 0.4 into 10⁻⁹ coulombs, and 4 pi epsilon naught. Epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10⁻², and RB value is 4. So by calculating this value, it is equal to 0.8987 volts. So in the last problem, we have to find the potential at A, that the value is equal to 3.595 volt. And here we find out the potential at B. This value is equal to 0.8987 volts. So in this problem, we have to find the value of potential difference between the points A and B. So the formula is potential difference V of AB is equal to V of A minus V of B. So this is the V of A value, that is 3.595, and this is the V of B value, that is 0.8987. So this value is equal to 2.6962 volts. So this is the final solution for potential difference between points A and B. Now the next problem: if 3 charges, 3 microcoulombs, 4 microcoulombs, 5 microcoulombs are located at 0, 0, 0, 2, -1, 3 and 0, 4, -2 respectively, find the potential at 1, 0, 1 assuming zero potential at infinity. So this is the point zero potential at infinity, which is named as capital A, and this point is 1, 0, 1. Now these are the three charges, 0, 0, 0, and q2 2, -1, 3, and q3 0, -4, -2, and corresponding charges are at q1, that is 3 microcoulombs, at q2 -4 microcoulombs, at q3 it is equal to 5 microcoulombs. Now the potential at A due to q1 is expressed as VA1 q1 by 4 pi naught R1. Similarly, the potential at A due to q2 is VA2 by q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught R2, and the potential at A due to q3 is expressed as VA3 q3 by 4 pi epsilon naught R3. Here R1 is the distance between q1 and A, and R2 is the distance between q2 and A. R3 is the distance between q3 and A. So first we find the potential at A due to q1 is expressed as VA1 is equal to q1 by 4 pi epsilon naught R1. Now let us discuss the next step, the difference is the distance between the point q1 and A is R1, that is difference between the points square root of 1 minus 0 whole square, 0 minus 0 whole square, plus 1 minus 0 whole square. So square root of 1, 0 minus 0 is 0, plus 1, that is a square root 2. And for charge q1 it is 3 microcoulombs. So microcoulombs is converted into coulombs by multiply with 10 power minus 6. So VA1 is equal to q by 3 × 10⁻⁶ by 4 pi epsilon naught R1. So that is also here we find that value is equal to root 2. Now substitute this here. By calculating this values, finally potential at A due to q1 charge is 19.0658 kilovolts. Now next we calculate the potential at A due to q2 is, so this is the expression VA2 by is equal to q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught R2. Now R2 is the distance between the points, that is so here that is 2 1 minus 2 whole square, plus 0 minus 1 whole square, plus 1 minus 3 whole square. Here the points are, when you observe this, these are the points. So 1 minus 2 whole square, 0 minus 1 whole square, 1 minus 3 whole square. So this is the distance between the points. Its value is equal to 1 minus 2 whole square, means 1 square. Here also the value is 1 square, plus 1 minus 3 is -2 whole square, that is 4. So 1 plus 1 plus 4. So this value is equal to root 6. Now substitute the charge value q2 and distance between the q2 and A, that is root 6, in this expression. Then it is equal to charge value is -4 microcoulombs, that is -4 × 10⁻⁶, and 4 pi epsilon naught R12 is value is equal to root 6. Now by calculating these values, this value is equal to -14.6769 kilovolt. In the same way, we have to also find the value of potential of A due to Q3 is expressed as Q3 by 4 pi epsilon naught R3. Here also we have to find the distance between the point A and to the charge Q3, and that is square root of 1 minus 0 whole square plus 0 minus 4 whole square plus 1 minus of minus 2 whole square. That means 1 square plus 4 square plus 3 square. This value is equal to 26, and the charge Q3 is given in the problem 5 microcoulombs. So change into coulombs, therefore substitute the values Q3 and R3 in this expression. Therefore VA3 value is equal to Q3 value is 5 into 10 power minus 6 coulombs by 4 pi epsilon naught, and R3 value is root 26, and this calculated value is equal to, that means here the epsilon naught value is taken as 8.8542 into 10 power minus 12. So this value is equal to finally VA3 is equal to 8.8132 kilovolt. Now we have to calculate the total potential at point A due to charge Q1 and Q2 and Q3 is the vector sum of all potentials, that is the total potential. That means VA1 plus VA2 plus VA3 is the total potential at A. So by adding VA1 and VA2 value and VA3 value here, the total potential at A is 13.2021 kilovolts. And the next problem. A point charge 6 nanocoulombs is located at origin in free space. Find the potential of point P if P is located at 0.2, minus 0.4, 0.4, and V is equal to 0, that is at infinity. V is equal to 0 at 1, 0, 0, and V is equal to 20 volts at minus 0.5, 1, minus 1. So this is the figure represents the position of Q and P. Here Q is origin, so its coordinates are 0, 0, 0, and point P given in the problem, that is 0.2 minus 0.4 and 0.4, and now the charge at origin is 6 nanocoulombs. Now the potential at infinity, reference at infinity, hence the potential at the point is Vp at point P is Vp. So the expression for potential at point P is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rp. So Rp means distance between origin and to the point, so that is measured as a square root of 0.2 minus 0 whole square plus minus 0.4 whole square, 0.4 minus 0 whole square. So this value is equal to 0.6. now Q value is given in the problem, that is 6 nanocoulombs, and Rp value also we have here, we find it, that value is equal to 0.6. now these values are substituted in this expression, so that is 6 into 10 power minus 9 coulombs by 4 pi epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10 power minus 12, and Rp value is 0.6. this value is equal to 89.8774 volts. Here we have to take the V is equal to 0 at infinity, that means the reference is at infinity, hence the formula is used in this expression. Now the next problem, V is equal to 0 at point 1, 0, 0, that means this is the another point. So we have to find the reference is not an infinity, but in such a case potential P is the is written as Vp is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rp plus C. So here C is a constant, so that constant value first of all we have to find that. So so V R, that means potential at R, first we find that. Why? Because at the point P it is the sum of the potential due to origin, charge at origin and the potential due to point R. So that's why here we have to write the Vp is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rp plus C. C is the potential at 1 comma 0 comma 0. So we have to find that value. So by using the by condition, the potential at R is 0. So here it is the expression for Vr. Vr value is q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rr plus C is equal to 0. Here Rr is the difference between origin point and to the R. So that is 1 minus 0 whole square plus 0 minus 0 whole square plus 0 minus 0 whole square. This value is equal to 1. Therefore, there is a condition potential at R value is 0. So simply Vr value is taken as a 0 and charge is 6 into 10 power minus 9 Q at the origin by 4 pi epsilon naught. Epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 and distance between the points that is R value is 1. So finally C value is equal to minus 53.92644. So substitute the C value here, then V is equal to 0 at 1 comma 0 0. In such a case the potential at P is obtained. So here the q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rp value is already we have to find in this case, that is 89.8774 value. And by using this formula we find out the value of C, that is minus 53.92664. Now substitute in this value C and potential at P due to origin values, then the potential at P due to this point R is 35.9509 volt. The next problem, the same model, here the point is only changed. So in the same similar manner, so we have to expression for the potential at P with reference to the point M value is Vp is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rp plus C. But we did not know the value of C. So the C value measure with the help of potential at M. So that potential at M value is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rm plus C. So here the potential at the point M is given by 20 volts and the Rm is the differences between or distance between point M to the origin. So that is square root of minus 0.5 whole square, 1 whole square minus 1 whole square. This is equal to 1.5. Now in this expression, substitute the Vm value as a 20 volts that is given in the problem and Q as the charge that is 6 into 10 power minus 9 and 4 pi epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 and Rm is the distance between point M and origin, that is 1.5 plus C. So by calculating all these values C value is equal to -15.9509. So the potential at P with reference point M is expressed as Vp is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rp plus C. Here the potential at P is with the help of already we have to find in the first case, that is A. This value is equal to 89.8774, and the C value is equal to -15.9509. So the total potential due to the reference of a point M is equal to 73.9264 volt. The next problem. The electric field intensity E bar is negative gradient of scalar potential. That is called the relation between E and V. So this is the problems based on potential gradient. So find E bar at the point P 0, 1, 1 if potential V is equal to E naught e power minus x sine pi y by 4 in a Cartesian coordinate system. And also another problem, V is equal to E naught r cos theta in a spherical coordinate system. That means it is clearly given in the problem. In first case we have to use Cartesian coordinate system. That means expression for volume or expression for surface, whatever it may be, these are taken in Cartesian coordinate system. Similarly, in the second problem, we have to use a spherical coordinate system. Now, the first problem, V is equal to E naught e power minus x sine pi y by 4. So, here we have to use the relation between E and V, that is E bar is equal to minus del V. So the expression for divergence, the gradient of V is equal to dou V by dou X AX bar plus dou V by dou Y AY bar plus dou V by dou Z AZ bar. So initial first we find the values of dou V by dou X value and dou V by dou Y value and dou V by dou Z value for this potential. Then substitute these values in this expression. Then we get the value of electric field intensity. And also substitute the X, Y, Z values as 0, 1, 1. So first we have to find the value of dou V by dou X for this expression. That means partial derivative of potential at with respect to X. So that means the remaining all are taken as a constant. So this is the potential. Here E naught is constant and sine pi y by 4 is constant because we have to derivative with respect to x. So the variable is only e power minus x. So E naught sine pi y by 4, the derivative of e power minus x is minus 1 into e power minus x. And the next, with respect to y, that means E naught and e power minus x are taken as a constant. Now the sine of pi y by 4 is equal to cos pi y by 4, and again the differentiate the value inside the bracket, that is pi y by 4, it is equal to pi by 4. And the next, dou v by dou z value. Here the expression of voltage, when you observe that there is no z component, so simply dou v by dou z value is equal to 0. So by knowing the values of dou v by dou x and dou v by dou y value, now substitute in this expression. So that is minus e naught e power minus x sine pi y by 4 ax bar plus E naught e power minus x pi by 4 cos pi y by 4 a y bar volt per meter. Now potential at point p 0 comma 1 comma 1, that means simply substitute the values of x is equal to 0, so x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 1 in both equations. So finally values are e naught is taken as a common, so e naught 0.7071 ax bar minus 0 point, so this value is equal to e naught 0.7071 ax bar minus 0.555 ay bar volt per meter. Now the second problem is potential V is equal to E naught R cos theta. Here we have to solve the problem with respect to given by spherical coordinate system. So the expression for del V in a spherical coordinate system is dou V by dou R AR bar plus 1 by R dou V by dou theta A theta bar plus 1 by r sin theta dou v by dou phi a phi bar. So we have to derivative, partial derivative with respect to r theta and phi by these potential and substitute in this expression, then we get the answer for electric field intensity. So first we have to find the value of dou v by dou r, so that is equal to E naught cos theta, and dou V by dou theta, that is minus E naught R sin theta. In this expression there is no phi value, so dou V by dou phi is equal to 0. Now substituting all these equations in E bar is equal to minus del V expression, then E bar value is equal to minus E naught cos theta AR bar plus E naught sin theta A theta volt per meter. But we have to find the electric field intensity at the point P 0 comma 1 comma 1 in a spherical coordinates. So convert the these points into R phi theta, because these points are in a Cartesian coordinate system, that is these values are x, y and z. So convert these values into r theta phi. The relation between or the conversion of Cartesian coordinate to spherical coordinate system, that is we have to discuss in basics in vectors. So by using that formulas, r value is equal to square root of x square plus y square plus z square. That means square root of x square is 0 square, y square is 1 square and z square is 1 square. That means r value is equal to root 2. Similarly, phi value is obtained by tan inverse of y by x. Here y is 1 and x is 0. That means 1 by 0. So that is tan inverse of infinity. And this value is equal to pi by 2. Next, theta is obtained by cos inverse of z by r. Here z is 1 and r we have to find here, that is root 2, and that means cos inverse of 1 by root 2. So this value is equal to 45 degrees. So finally we got the values of r, phi and theta with respect to Cartesian points 0 comma 1 comma 1. So simply substitute these values in this above equation. E naught cos theta, that is cos 45 degrees, next sin theta, next that is equal to sin 45 degrees. By substituting these values here, the electric field intensity at the point P 0 comma 1 comma 1 by taking spherical coordinates as a reference is equal to E bar is equal to E naught minus 0.7071 plus 0.7071 A theta volt per meter. Now the next problem. an electric potential is given by V is equal to 60 sin theta by R square volt. Find the voltage and electric field intensity at a point P 3 comma 60 degrees comma 25 degrees. That means initially they given the values of spherical coordinate system, so that is very easy to substitute the values directly. There is no conversion of Cartesian coordinate system to spherical coordinate system. That means at a point P 3 comma 60 degrees comma 25 degrees means these are the variables R theta phi. So R value is 3, theta value is 60 degrees, and phi value is 25 degrees. So V is equal to 60 sine 60 by 3 square. That is, this value is equal to 5.7735 volt. So we easily find the value of V potential, but we have to find the value of E. So the relation between E and V is E is equal to minus del V. So del V with reference to spherical coordinate system expression is dou V by dou R AR bar plus 1 by R dou V by dou theta A theta plus 1 by R sine theta dou V by dou phi A phi bar. So first of all, we find the values of dou V by dou R, dou V by dou theta, and dou V by dou phi with respect to potential V is equal to 60 sine theta by R square. So here 60 sine theta, R square is the only variable function here, because here we partial derivative with respect to R. So 1 by R square is differentiation is minus 2 into R power minus 3. So it is minus 120 sin theta by R cube. And next we have to partial derivative with respect to theta. So here the variable is only sin theta. That means differentiation of sin theta is equal to cos theta. So 60 by R square cos theta. Here there is no phi term in this expression. So simply the partial derivative with respect to phi value is equal to 0. Now substitute the values of dou V by dou R and dou V by dou theta in this expression. Minus of minus 120 sin theta by R cube AR bar plus 1 by R 60 by R square cos theta A theta bar. Now here, given in the problem, theta value is 60 degrees. Now substitute that theta is equal to 60 here. That is minus 120 sin 60 by 3 cube AR bar plus 60 by 3 cube cos 60 A theta bar. These values are equal to, that means final electric field intensity is 3.849 AR bar minus 1.111 A0 A theta volt per meter. So these are the problems based on electric potential. So we have to discuss the what is formula problems based on electric potential and potential difference, and also we have to also discuss the problems on potential gradient also. Now, thank you.